Hi, I'm Patty with Studio R12. Today we're going to learn how to paint on cork. On my palette, I have got, this is one of our reusable palettes. It's made out of the mylar we use for our stencils. I've got, I think it's number 28. I don't have the number on there. That's black, number 34 and number 44. And if you want to see our whole collection of 80 colors, this is a product that is available too, so that you know exactly what colors we're using to do the projects. We need to decide on our placement. Because cork is a unique surface, a unique texture, I'm a little concerned that my tape might get a little too sticky. So what you do is you take your jeans and you just stick that tape on your jeans just to fuzz it up just a little bit, and that'll make my tape not grab that cork too much. So I will choose my placement. I'm gonna go offset to the lower left side. And then I'm gonna wanna place my tape. I think because I've got all of the different movement things going on, I'm going to probably over tape. Usually I only take two little spots on opposite sides, but I wanna make sure I don't have my stencils slip. I'll get one more piece. And that fuzzing off on your tape is just such a really good trick. The other thing that I might want to do is grab something that's the same height as my stencil, so my stencil has some support. Okay, so I'll just stick these two rolls of tape down there. And now where the stencil weight over here wants to lift or bend over the edge of my journal, it won't do that because it has a support underneath of it. So you could stack up little boards, you could use pieces of cardboard stacked up or whatever you wanted to do. Okay, so we're gonna use a palette knife and we're gonna make a browny gray color using 44 and 34, about equal. So what I'm doing is instead of adding water to lighten my color, I'm adding a softer color to lighten my color. So wipe off my palette knife. I'm gonna pick up just a little bit of black. What I'm wanting to do here is I'm wanting to make the gray color that I'm mixing, I'm wanting to make it be a family member with the black, which I'm gonna use for the shading. So I'm just putting just a little bit of black in there to make it be family. And that makes a lovely, lovely taupey gray. Kind of a khaki color. Don't be afraid of mixing colors, it is so much fun. So I'm gonna pick up with my dry brush, just a little bit of my paint on the end of the brush, and then I'll come on my paper towel down here and I will just wipe it off. We're offloading always. And now glasses on. And on these skinny lines, I might not get a very good line if I swirl, so I might need to stipple over there. But I really do want to see what my, oh, it's not even showing at all. Might need to mix a little bit darker. There we go. I just offloaded too much. Right here where I've got my little off the rim, I think I actually am gonna take care of that right now. We're gonna tape that edge and keep the paint out of there. I did not off stick that, but I believe because we have such a small rim right there, I don't think it'll cause a problem. We'll pick up our color again and we can peek right now and see what we think of that color. And so yeah, that's gonna look really pretty. Offload. As you wear it off, reload. Start when you reload your paint and then you've offloaded and you come back to your project. Start with a soft, soft pressure so that that way you don't make it too dark because you have fresh paint on there. Or just talk to the camera for a little while and it'll wear off or dry up. Like how fast, how fun to be able to personalize presents and gifts for people make something just really extraordinary. Artist presents for your teachers. You can make Bible study journals for your friends. If you go to studioR12.com, we have almost 7,000 titles of stencils. So we've got you covered. Now on my edges, I'm probably gonna need to stipple. Yeah, it's doing it. So I'm gonna go in the direction of the cut. Okay. And now I'm gonna put that brush in water. I'm gonna pick up the 1/4 inch brush and some black paint. And what you'll do with this, I wanna shade into the corners. That's where my paint is gonna be strongest. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is start in that corner and take that piece of fuzz. Sometimes your paper towels will transfer fuzz. And I'm doing so light a pressure. We get our multi-masker out. And I wanna just kind of drag that out. So when you start in the corner, it'll be darkest there. And then when you drag it out, it'll start getting lighter just on its own. And you go softer, softer pressure. Okay, and that is gonna look like, yeah, maybe we'll do it a little bit bigger. So go in that corner and then move out a little bit quicker. Yeah, and then we'll go over here and do the same thing. By using these smaller brushes, you have a lot more control on things. So I think that looks good. And then we're just going to repeat on all the different elements. I'm gonna do just these. I may not do these. I think I wanna wait and see what it looks like once we get going. So I think maybe what I'll do is I'll go down this row right here and we'll see what it looks like. Okay, now let's take a look and see what we think. Always be a peeker. Okay, so yeah, that just makes a really neat effect coming out of there. So we might even go back in and do just a little bit of deepening right there. So I'll just layer it and stipple just right in the corner. So it gives it a pop. Okay, and now we'll repeat on all the other elements. I think I'm going to switch from this brush to my tiniest brush and just kind of, I'm offloading but not very much, just kind of brush it at that little corner. I like the graduated effect. Okay, got one more thing that I want to take care of, and that is I want to spatter on this area. So what I will do is I will mask the area of my project that will not be getting spatters. And then we'll take some water and some black paint and a heavy handle brush. I love this feathering brush, the giant one. For this, you always test off, but I need more water. Okay, I like the size of those big juicy spatters right there. Spatters stay wet for a really long time, so be careful about letting it have enough dry time, because a spatter that is wet will smear, and then you will be sad. Okay, let's take a look. I'm gonna pull it straight up and over. I'm probably gonna peel some of this tape off. Didn't stick at all. Pretty happy about that. And then straight up, and ta-da! Look at how pretty that is. Just a nice, elegant look. And I think we could use one more effect on this, and I think it's metallic. All right, I want to put a little bit of gold sparkle. So I have some splendid gold from DecoArt, and I'm going to, if you notice here, I had a brand new bottle. I've got this oozing liquid out there, and that is the medium that makes the paint painty. And so that is oozing out of the edges, and that means my bottle of paint is not shook up. If your paint doesn't look like the yolk of an egg when you spit it out, then you haven't shaken your paint enough. And so we'll add some water. I got very dirty water over here. I'm toning my gold as I go. See how our spatters look? Okay. And so what we want to do is just kind of create just a visual effect out. It just gives it a little shazowy. Yeah, and I think maybe we'll add some bigger black spatters out here. So not too much sampling off so I get the big fat black spatters. You could kind of take and make almost a shadowed effect going at the base. It anchors it just a little bit. It doesn't look like it's falling off the edge. And maybe we'll give just a little bit. Did you know you could paint with spatters? If you are enjoying this, make sure that you go to our YouTube channel while you're seeing this on YouTube, but make sure that you subscribe and ring the bell to get notifications. And then do make sure you go to our website and check out all the good stuff we've got. So we're gonna just anchor that upper corner and round it out just a little bit. And maybe we'll do all four corners. Make sure that you're arching to finish it. Yeah, that looks really nice. Ta-da. All right, guys, what a fun and easy project this was. I hope that you check us out on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and of course our website, Studio R12. Happy crafting.